Now we can write down a general method for impact problems. And as has been the case in the past, the very first step to solving problems is to choose a coordinate system and draw it. Okay. The step two is to draw impact relevant free body diagram of the system as a whole. So if you have two particles colliding against each other, then you draw a free body diagram with two particles together. And remember, we are looking for impact relevant free body diagram. So which means that the forces that are not impulsive should not be shown in this free body diagram. So draw impact relevant free body diagram of the system as a whole and of individual particles. Okay, so which means that you are not going to show, so do not show non-impulsive forces. So what are the non-impulsive forces? Gravity is one, elastic forces, some normal forces, not all, but some normal forces. Okay. And we have seen before that there are normal forces that can grow as large as possible in magnitude, and that's when they become impulsive forces. So for example, if you have two particles A and B that collide against each other while traveling on a horizontal surface, then there are normal reactions acting on A and B at all times, even before they collide, and these normal forces are not impulsive forces. So these are non-impulsive forces, because at the time of impact, their magnitude does not become large because they are not contributing towards the change in momentum of the particle. On the other hand, if I take the same particle and I throw it down on a horizontal surface at the time of impact, the normal force that develops between the particle and the surface is going to be an impulsive force, because it can grow as large as possible in magnitude without violating the constraints of the system, which means that the particle is really not allowed to go through the horizontal surface. Okay, so there are certain kinds of normal forces that could be impulsive, certain others that may not be impulsive forces. So you have to kind of look for both of them. And then when you draw the impact relevant free body diagram, you only show the impulsive forces. Then the step three is, after you have drawn the free body diagram, to identify the directions in which linear momentum can be conserved. Okay, so it is possible that linear momentum may not be conserved in one direction, or it could be conserved in some other direction. If they can be conserved, if it can be conserved in both directions, then that's even better. Okay. Step four is to write down the conservation of linear momentum statement or principle in the identified directions, which you did in step three. Okay. And step five is, because mostly the conservation of linear momentum principle alone won't be sufficient to solve the problem, write the E equation. So the E equation is the equation, of course, for coefficient of restitution, which relates the separation velocity with the approach velocity. And finally, of course, we will identify the unknowns and solve for them using the equations that you opt in step number 4 and step number 5.